Hello and welcome to Make, Learn and Play. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a children's aquarium out of cardboard, which will hopefully look a little bit like this. So first of all, you need to find an empty box. You will need to cut the flaps off on either side. Draw a line across the top and cut them with two slits all the way along, so when you hang your fish, you have somewhere to move the fish along. Then you need to draw two portholes either side of the box. Once you've done that, cut out the holes, cut the slits, and then you will need to mix up some paper mache glue in a bowl, and then shred newspaper ready
just
to stick
before you
on
mache
the box.
Paper mache the box, it's a good idea to take some lollipop sticks
and thread it just through the top where the slits are, just to strengthen the box a little bit more. Otherwise, if the children pull on the fish, it may collapse. But the paper mache should also strengthen the box to make it a little bit more
secure.
As you
can see, I'm slowly putting paper mache glue on the box
and then placing the newspaper. You'll probably need to cover the whole box, and then once it's dry, it will be ready to paint. Choose which colour you would like to paint. Sometimes white's a good idea, because then once it's dry, you can paint on the inside whatever colour you would like for your aquarium. It's also a good idea if your children are around to get them to help you do this, as this can be quite time consuming. Okay, so once you've paper mache'd your cardboard box and it's now looking something like this, we then need to get some ready mix paint and paint the whole outside of the box.
Okay, I'm just painting the box. Because of it being newspaper underneath, it may take a couple of coats. I'm using white ready mix paint, quickly splashing the bottom coat on. It is drying quite quickly, and hopefully once that's dry, a second coat should be enough to cover over the newspaper.
And then once your children are home, they can help you paint the box.
That's it, Ollie. Put some more paint on your brush.
They can help too.
Yeah, for Daddy, Freddy and me.
Yeah, that's it.
And Daddy.
You keep helping paint then. Well done. And then what colour are we going to paint the inside, Ollie? What colour do you think the inside should be for a fish tank?
Outside.
What colour is the sea?
Blue.
Good boy. Okay, right, let's turn the box around now.
No.
And we'll take the back.
Now.
There you go. Paint that for me then. Okay, so the next thing we need to do, whilst we're waiting for the box to dry, we need four circles for our portholes to go around the rim. So the flaps that we cut off the cardboard box at the beginning, we can now recycle and use for portholes. So we need four. I'm just going to draw around some masking tape, wrong, one, two, three, four. And then what we need to do is cut them out. In fact, we need to go inside first. One, two, and cut the middle out of the portholes. If you wanted to, you don't have to use cardboard. You could use some foam rings.
draw around the middle of that and cut that out as well. Maybe replace it with that. It's up to you.
Okay, so once you've cut your four rings for your portholes, which I have here, you can then get some cellophane. You can choose whichever colour you would like. I've actually chosen blue. So when you look through the porthole windows, it looks like you're looking at the sea, as you can see. And then just paste in some PVA glue around the outside. Here. Okay, and then you just place it in the middle. And then once that's dried, just cut around the outside. Okay, now I've stuck cellophane on the portholes, as you can see. And I've now decided, just so they look a bit neater and tidier once you add them to the aquarium box, that I think it would look nicer if they were painted. So it's up to you. You can decide whether you would like to leave the natural cardboard colour or you could paint them like I am. Or get your children to paint them. Just makes them look a little bit more tidier. Okay, so once your box is fully painted, inside and out, then we need to look at adding our portholes. Go on just like this. So if you get some PVA glue like this, and then a paintbrush, some in a bowl, and then just add a small amount just around the outside of your window, just like so, and then gently onto the box. Okay, let's get another one. There we go. That side. Gently place. Oops. Onto. Put a little bit of pressure on there. Stick. Okay, so then you can turn the box around and do the other side. So the next thing we need to do is concentrate on the background of the aquarium. So it's a good idea to get as many blue different pieces of material as possible. So I've got some cellophane, some tissue paper, so I'll probably use the green and blue tissue paper out of here. And then also a good idea is to get some blue paint, and then do strokes across the paper, just roughly, it doesn't have to be neat. So if you do a blue one, just on A4 paper, or whatever size paper you've got, and then do another piece in green, and then once that's dried, if you tear up the paper, and then you can stick it to the back of the aquarium. Just like so. Let's try and get the sea effect. Try and keep the brush marks going all the same way. doesn't matter if you can see a little bit of the white through the paint. So there's a green one, and then you need to do a green one and allow that one to dry. Okay, now I'm just painting through the green. It's quite nice to have a few brush marks to try and capture the wave effect. And then just wait for that one to dry. Okay, so once you've painted your blue and green, if you wanted to, you could add some glitter to go on the top before it dries. So then once it's all dry, you can start clearing the paper. Good idea to have some newspaper underneath to catch all the excess glitter. There we go. As much as you like, enough to cover the back. Some tissue paper, like this. And then some cling film, and of all different thicknesses if you like. Upside down and place PVA glue all across the back of the box, ready to put on your sheets of paper. Okay, so once you've decorated the back of the aquarium, you can then do the same on the bottom, but take different colour blue tissue paper, do the same. You can have looser bits. So sugar as much as you can to cover quite a large area. And add your glue. Slowly you can start adding looser bits of paper to create a wave. And then once all this is done, you're ready to make your sea creatures, which is a fantastic job for the children to do. So as you can see, we're trying to create the wave effect by placing down tissue paper on the glue, just spread all over the base, and lift some of the paper up and slowly put down in other areas and just let it naturally fall. you're slowly getting there. And then you just try and fill in the gaps. Loose the pieces. Okay, and then with the leftovers, just place them in. Try and cover as much as the area as possible. Another idea whilst you're waiting for it all to dry before you start making your fish is with some leftover cardboard from the box, you could draw some seaweed and stick on the inside of the aquarium walls. So I've just done a wiggly shape, cut it out, paint it green, do on this side as well. Just to add a little bit more of a sea effect. There we go. So we just need to cut them out, paint them, and then stick them on the inside.
Okay, so the next thing we are doing is painting some fish. So we've got some polystyrene, eggs. So Freddie, what colour are you painting yours?
Green.
Jasmine, what colour are you painting red. Yours? Ollie, what colour are you going to paint yours?
Blue.
Blue. Okay, go on then, carry on. The aquarium's coming on nicely.
Oh, that looks lovely, Jasmine.
I used to do this one.
Get a
kebab
stick.
Woo!
Kebab
stick.
Poke a hole.
All the way.
All the way
through. Cool.
There you go.
Sit down and put that. I just want to see what that
is. Oh my,
this comes off.
Okay, let's have Holly.
Oh, that's not good.
Okay.
Mommy, do we do it like this now?
No, just paint it, darling, please.
Just like that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Jasmine, are you going to do another one?
Yes, please.
Okay, hold on a second then. Well, Ollie, can you finish doing that one?
It looks very ready, bluey.
I get another one for Jasmine.
Oh no,
my name. Right, who's going to need somebody to do a yellow one then?
Me, I'll do that after.
Me!
And just find another paintbrush. Just. Can you get
on it? Thank you. Molly, go do it.
Well done, Ollie, that's lovely.
Go do it. I've got a leaf paintbrush.
Okay, let's put one through for Jasmine. There we go. I guess call you fishes then.
I know what I'm getting.
What about the first, the big egg ones, Freddy, Jess and Ollie?
Yeah, I did it!
Good boy, Ollie. Well done.
It's easier for Ollie.
I'll hold this as well then, darling. Okay.
Mum, should I put that on there as well?
Put one in there, yeah. Good boy.
They're going to be
easy. This is my collection. That's Jess's collection.
Yeah.
The blue ones are...
And then, once they've dried, and over the newspaper,
yeah.
Sprinkle. Just slowly, because it comes out really quick. Okay, make sure you catch it all on the newspaper, Freddie, so we can keep it for later. Wow, yours looks like a world.
Sparkle world! Mm-hmm. What are
we doing? Do you want to do some sprinkles on yours, some glitter?
I'm going
to
do another fish.
What colour should we do on this one?
Blue.
Do you want to do on this one as well?
I want
green.
I want sort of sparkles.
Okay, what have you got then?
I want it.
Shake it then. Oh, hold on, lift it higher. There we go. Beautiful.
Mommy, this
one's done, Ollie.
Mummy, this one's quite hard to open.
Jasmine, what colour are you using?
What colour? I want that colour.
Silver?
Yeah.
Okay, that'll do, Freddie. You can leave yours to dry now. Well done.
We know
then,
anymore.
Once they're dry, you can come back and decorate them. Yeah. Okay, put it to dry then. That's it, Jasmine. Shake it a little bit more. Oh, not too much.
Whoa!
Okay, you finished?
I can just
roll
it.
Okay. What colour are you after? Colour? Glitter, do you want some of the red one?
I do green.
Or don't you? You don't have to.
I want...
Just leave them there, Freddie, I'll clean that up.
That can be a mix of different colours, that would be good.
Ooh. Jasmine, what would you like?
What can we do this one?
Can I have... What sparkles are they?
Green, silver, or blue.
Ollie, yours will end up like that. Well, sooner, something's in there.
Okay, are you finished, Freddie?
That's
it. Well done. Excellent. Whoa, not too much. Turn it over.
Turn it over the other way.
Turn it over. Or you can roll it in that if you want to. Just roll it in it.
Yeah, roll it in it. Can I do that?
No, you've got enough on.
Can I just do it?
Go on then.
Should I do that?
Yeah.
I think I'll do it.
Mm-hmm. On which one? This one? And then?
I want to do it.
Look at mine.
There we go. Excellent. Well done then, guys. Thank you.
I'm just going to
decorate them once they're dry, yeah?
Two octopuses to go in the bottom of the aquarium. Okay?
We can mold it in the paper.
So what do you have to do? Do you know? So what are you doing? You're rolling a small ball.
A small ball.
Like this.
In the paint.
In the paint. Ah. You're using a paintbrush?
No.
No? Why not? Looks like a lollipop.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. A blue one.
It's a good idea to put them on the skewers so then you can put them to dry easy.
Yeah.
And then we've got some, do you know what these are called?
Is that enough?
Yeah, well done.
And now a yellow one. Now a yellow one.
So then we get the, can use the pipe cleaners, remember pipe cleaners? And then how many legs do octopuses have? Do you know?
Eight.
Well done. So we can fold them over, so if we get four that are the same size.
Daddy, I'll do this one first.
So measure. So there's two there. Jasmine has made some little heads for octopuses. We're now getting some pipe cleaners.
Yeah.
Now how many do we need?
Eight.
Octopuses have eight legs, you're right, but we only need four pipe cleaners. One, two, three, and try and make sure they're the same length so you can cut them. Four. We've got four pipe cleaners, and then if you fold them over each other. So how many legs have we got there?
Four.
Four, good girl. And then we get another one. Fold that one over.
Six.
Good girl. And then one more. Use that color. And then how many have we got left?
Six.
No, we had six before. How many have we got now?
Eight.
Good girl. So when the head's dry, we can, some PVA glue, stick the head on,
put some gobbly eyes on. And then there's our octopus. Okay, so we need to let that one dry. Yep, well done. Just take some of that paint off. Okay, there we go. We can leave them all to dry and then we can add the legs.
Okay, so what we're going to do next, Ollie, now all the foam balls and eggs have dried like this. We're going to get our goggly eyes.
Okay.
Let's open them up.
Mummy, we need to know.
Yep, let's get you a little paintbrush. Put that in the glue as well. Hold on, 1 second, Mum.
I need some blue.
And our pipe cleaner. So we've got our octopus legs. Okay, so we need a small amount of glue just on here, Ollie. Just where Mummy's finger is. Okay, a little bit more.
No.
Okay, good boy. Tiny bit more. And goggly eyes. Right, because he's got quite a small head, so I think we should have smaller eyes. Okay?
Okay.
So, once we put our glue on there, which colour head should we have for our octopus?
Blue.
Blue, okay. So we stick his head on like that. Can you do it? Push it down for me. Hold it down. And then we need to put a tiny bit of glue on the eyes. Ready? Mind your fingers a sec. Stick one on. There, one. There's the other one. Okay. And then the other one. Okay, let go.
Now we
What about octopuses?
A baby.
And here's some we made earlier.
Octopus.
One. Two. And then place them. You can bend his legs however you like.
Mummy.
A little bit more blue on there. There we go. And let's put him over here to dry.
Mummy.
So place those ones in our aquarium. There's two. And then next we need to start creating the rest of our fish so we can add some tails. So
I
take the skewers off.
Ones.
Yeah, we can do that one in a minute. So let's take the skewers.
And that one.
Yeah, and that one. We'll make them in a minute. Right, okay, so what's this going to be?
A fish.
A fish, right. So what do fishes have? How do they swim? What moves?
Tail.
Tail, good boy. So now we need to make a tail, a bit like
what we do
this one.
Like that.
Okay, so let's find some. Okay, which colour should we use? Should we use purple, yellow, pink? What would you like to use?
Blue.
One of these ones then?
Yeah.
Okay, so now we need to make it into a
fishy tail.
A fishy tail, okay?
Like this.
Turn
one.
It. And then if your mummy finds the end of the pipe cleaner, the sharp bit, can hopefully poke that through. Well done.
Mummy, I'm going to hold it.
Yeah. Do you want to stick the eyes on while I make the tail? Should we have big eyes on this one? Big eyes?
Yeah.
Right, put a bit of glue on. On the eyes. No, on the eyes. Oh, actually, do you want to put it on there, though? So we need one this side.
This side.
Mm. You stick the eye on. Put the eye on there.
This eye or this way.
There we go. There's one side. And then you turn it over. Put some glue on. And we'll stick the other one. 1 second. Put more glue on. On that side. Can you put it on?
Yay!
Good boy.
And now we need.
And then we just need to put his tail on. And then we can add the string and hang him in the aquarium.
Like that.
Okay. Now we put some on his fish as well. Put his eyes on. Ollie.
One here.
Okay, so put one on there then.
One this one here.
Where the glue is. Has he got little eyes, this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Another little eye.
Yeah, where the glue is there. Good boy. That's it.
Now.
And then when you take the skewers out, we can put the string through. Can't wait to...
Sorry. We can put the tails on.
And then we can hang our fishes in the aquarium, can't we?
Yeah, I mean, we can remove
the
tails.
Yeah, we need to have the tails. That'd be the tails are a little bit more tricky, so Mummy might have
you
to
get another the tails.
Good boy. Okay. Put that one to dry. This one.
Look how pretty this one.
What's that? That's tiny, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, put his eyes on as well.
I don't know which one.
Oh, that's really small, that eye.
Oh. I know. Oh, no, which one. Not anyone.
Okay, put that one on the glue.
I got bigger my finger. Look.
Right, okay, so here's your eyes on this one.
I won't do it.
Hold on, let's put it back on its skewer for a second.
Mummy, I want to put some eyes on it.
Okay, you pick out some eyes then for this, because this is a little baby fish, isn't it?
Little one are dead. Wait.
Come on then, place that one on. Good boy.
No, little one. I think I'm a
good boy.
Now we need some more. Mommy, we need some more.
Okay, this one. Back on the skewer so it's easier to hold. So place a little bit more glue.
Okay, I put the eyes on so I can do it.
Okay, here we go. Good boy. Do you like making this, Ollie? Do you like making an aquarium? We're going to put it in your bedroom.
Yeah.
Good boy.
Mummy, now put in there.
There we go. Right, we need to leave these ones to dry and then...
We put in there.
And then we put them in the aquarium. Yeah. Well done. Okay, let's let them dry.
So with the tails,
if you grab the end of a sharp bit of the skewer, make a tiny little hole in the back of the fish. Add a little bit of PVA glue. There we go. And then leave to dry.
We're
going to add some, what colour towel should this one have then, Ollie?
Huh?
What colour towel should we put on this one? Have a look at these colours. What do you think might go nicely? So just add a little hole.
This one.
Take a little bit of polystyrene out.
Amy.
Okay, you want one like that?
Yeah.
Okay, so once the goggly eyes and the tails are attached to the fish, it's now up to you. You can decorate your fish in any way you like. You can cut up some triangles, make some fins. I just mix some red paint with a tiny bit of glue, and I've just decorated with a smiley face on. Then if I get another one, let that dry off. Get some more paint.
some blue ready mix paint. With a paintbrush, and you can decorate them however you like. Smiley face. Yeah. Some buttons. This one, and a red face. And just like that. Everything I've used to make the aquarium is from Cost Cutters Educational Supplies. There we go, leave them to dry. Okay, so once your fish have dried, you then need to add the string. So I've done one already to show you. Okay, so with your skewers, push all the way up through the hole, which you should already have before you painted them. And then decide what kind of length string you would like. You can use cotton, I'm just using string. Any colours that you like, doesn't matter. So tie a knot at the bottom so your fish doesn't fall through. Like so. Okay. And then you need to thread your string through the bottom of the fish. And if you're struggling, just give it a little poke. Okay, so once you've cut your string to the length that you would like, tie a knot in the bottom of the string and then thread it through the fish through the hole where your skewer was. If you're struggling to get the string through, or the cotton, then use the skewer just to help poke it through. Then you need a bead. So you thread the string through the bead, like so. There we go. And then just drop it over, tie a knot. There we go. And you can always trim the bottom of the string if you don't want to see that. Decide whereabouts you would like it to go. Poke through your slit at the top, and then there you have it. And the fish, and then work your way through with the bigger fish. Make sure you've got a decent size hole to thread through. So decide what kind of length you would like. Tie a knot. Okay, slowly push the string through your fish. little poke.
And so there we have it, one finished children's aquarium.
If you'd like to go to our website to see all of our resources, you can visit www.makelearnandplay.com. Thank you for watching.